Analyst is joining us right now to take some questions. Amnish Agarwal, Senior Vice President at Prabhudas Lilladher, is with us. He's been a veteran in the sector. He's been tracking companies for a long time. Amnish, good morning. First time on NDTV. Good to see you here. Prashant, this side.
Good morning.
I want to start with ITC, Amnish. So the government wants to introduce plain packaging in an attempt to reduce the appeal of smoking, and of course you know, it wants to do other things as well. I'm sure you've seen a lot of it, what the government and the union health minister wants to do, but how do you see this? Do you see some of these, if they were to put into effect, impacting ITC's prospects?
You see, there are two parts to it. One being that if you really want to curtail the spread of tobacco and the usage of tobacco in the country, you need to target all forms of tobacco, whether it is cigarettes, BD, or even some of the other, you can say, chewing tobacco, etc. So targeting cigarettes alone will not suffice the purpose. But having said that, whatever news in the media is coming, whatever steps the government is trying to implement and trying to get into, I think they are definitely going to impact the growth rate of cigarettes, and more so if it is not applied to other forms of tobacco. So to that extent, yes, it will be a dampener for the company, at least in the medium term.
You know, if ITC, say, for example, wants to say introduce new products, would it kind of be tough for ITC to do it if some of these plain packaging norms were to be introduced?
You see, in cigarettes as such, you can't undertake any media advertising. The advertising which the companies usually do is at the point of sale. Okay, so to that extent, plain packaging won't impact, but yes, it is also a fact that the kind of packaging the cigarette packs have, it's a kind of attraction to some of the new consumers. But having said that, more than two-thirds of the cigarette in this country, it is sold in the loose forms. That is, the people usually tend to buy one or two cigarettes whenever they want to smoke. So to that extent, the impact will be limited, but it would be wrong to say that there will be no impact.
Have you looked at, say for example, Australia introduced plain packaging sometime back, I think in 2012 or so. What was the impact?
You see, cigarette industry globally has been reporting decline in volumes. Not from last 1 or 2 years, but at least from the last 10 to 15 years. And it is as per the, you can say, various global legislations and the undertakings which the countries have given, that there has been a concerted effort to reduce the consumption of tobacco. So to that extent, as and when we move towards that, it is going to have implications. And whether, you see, one country implements it sooner or later, okay, definitely plain packaging will have some impact on the cigarette volumes.
Okay, let me ask you this. Do you see some of these regulations going through?
You see, it's difficult to say. Okay, whether these will be put through or not, it all depends upon the, you can say, the seriousness of the government in pushing these legislations through. But at the same time, tobacco industry is one of the chief revenue generators for the government in the form of excise. And also a lot of farmers' livelihood also depends upon tobacco cultivation. So to that extent, to what extent they will push it, it's slightly difficult to ascertain. But definitely, if you look at the past few months, the way excise duties have gone up for the third consecutive year in a row, the headwinds are definitely there for the cigarette companies.
You have a buy rating on ITC, right?
Yeah, we have accumulate rating on ITC. Target is around 380 rupees. And if you look at the stock in the past 12 months or so, it has been more or less range bound because of these uncertainties only.
When you say accumulate, you mean, if you were to see corrections, then your recommendation to clients is to buy it. I mean, use false to buy.
You see, one can buy now also, but it's better if one buys on declines, because the next budget is only 6 months away, and if the excise duty has to go up again in the next budget, so that would be a very bad blow to these companies. But at the same time, if there is no increase in the excise duty, because excise duty has increased in the month of July only, then one can definitely see some rally coming into cigarette stocks.
Okay, got that. You know, Amnish, we did some number crunching, some basic number crunching, and looked at the first quarter earnings, sector by sector. And let me just read out to you what we found was the actual growth for the FMCG sector. So, you know, we put out the actual growth in the first quarter, year on year. So we've got sales, EBITDA and profit, net level, and actual versus what was the consensus expectation. So sales growth for the sector came in at about 19.3%. It was about 5% higher than what was expected. EBITDA grew about 18.5%. That was about a 4-odd% beat. And at the net level, there was a 2% beat. The net profit growth was 11.4% or so. Amnish, have you worked out your own numbers? And can you attest to what we've put out, and what does it tell you?
You see, the numbers for the sector in general, they have been pretty impressive. Okay, although volume growth in select companies has seen a tendency to slow down, but a lot of companies have actually done a lot of cost control. Overheads have gone down in a few companies. So on a broad basis, margins have expanded and the profit growth has been quite impressive. So in a very broad manner, if you look, the sector has actually done quite well during the quarter.
But you'd expect, as you said, I mean, pricing actually contributed to bulk of the growth for more than one company. Volume growth was pretty small. Do you expect that to continue, or you think if the trend were to continue, it would start to show up in declining volumes? I mean, if the only growth is going to come from price inflation, eventually it will hurt sales.
You see, in the past 6 quarters, the volume growth in most of the companies has come off quite a bit. Okay, so now from the last couple of quarters, at least we are witnessing that the volume growth is actually forming a base and getting consolidated. In some of the companies, it is also showing signs of a faint revival. Okay, to that extent, I would say that I am not that much worried about the volume growth as of now, because the monsoons have recovered a bit. And if there is a general upturn coming in the economy, if the industrial recovery picks up, employment opportunities increase in the country, then the increased income levels of people will result in the much broad-based growth for the consumer demand in the coming years.
Okay, you have a buy rating on Britannia, and the stock has done very well. In a market which has done well, but I think it's fairly outperformed the rest of the market, the index, etc. What are the big reasons why you're bullish on Britannia?
You see, Britannia was operating in a sector which globally makes around 13-14% EBITDA margins. But despite this company being the second largest player in India, it was until last year operating with hardly 5.5-6% margins. So I would say that there has been a lot of sanity in the competition which biscuit industry was facing, but more importantly, there have been several steps initiated by Britannia in the past couple of years, like setting up multi-locational units, streamlining the various cost heads, streamlining manpower. So a lot of initiatives have gone from the company which have actually curtailed the costs, improved the margins, and moreover, I would say that even volume growth has started picking up. Because in the current quarter, they have reported 10% volume growth, so which is a strong bounce back. So we are very still positive on Britannia's prospects, and we believe that the company will continue to report above sector average earnings growth.
You know, if I've got this number right, the biscuits category has actually slowed down. January 2013, growth was 15%. In June 2014, the number is just 5.5% or so. are these numbers right? And what would this mean for Britannia if this slowdown were to continue?
Okay, you see, Britannia had seen sales slowing down from the past 2-3 quarters. For example, in FY14, their top line growth was around 12% in comparison to 15-16% earlier. But what they have done in the past year or so is they have gained 140% market share. Okay, and in the current quarter, they have posted around 15-15.5% top line growth. So the company has been actually gaining share. It is growing ahead of the market, and it is taking all the right steps that it, which suggests that the sales growth should continue.
What should the stock trade at according to you? I see that you got a price target of 1372 on this one. What are valuations? What are fair valuations?
You see, Britannia historically has been trading at a discount to the sector averages because the margins of this company have been very volatile. But if you look at, say, past couple of years now, the growth rates are coming up, margins have improved, and Britannia actually has better ROE and ROC than many of the other companies in the sector. It's a debt-free company, and now the cash is only going to get accumulated more and more, and it has got a dividend payout in excess of 40%. So we believe that we have valued the stock at 24 times June 16 earnings, but we believe that there is, if the company continues to perform the way it is, there is still some scope for further re-rating in the stock.
Okay. And you've interacted with the new management?
Yes.
The focus and the strategy all remains sort of consistent with what it was under Mrs. Vinita Bali?
You see, it's hard for me to say the that some of the initiatives, the benefits of which the company is reaping today, they were started 2-3 years back when the earlier management was in place. For example, they had started up setting up the units earlier only. But if you ask me, in the past, say, 12-18 months, some of the initiatives, more so in the supply chain, on the saving of the energy costs, in extending the approach to set up the multi-locational units, and in distribution, adopting split distribution strategy in urban areas and rural distribution, I think these are some of the initiatives taken by the new management. And in addition to it, they have also elevated a lot of the middle management people in the organization. So, which has rejuvenated the entire top rung of the company. So, I believe it is, I won't say that the earlier management was not doing well or anything of that sort, but I would say it is more like the work was started by the earlier management, and these people have actually taken it forward in a very well-conceived manner.
Okay, got that. Amnish, let's move on to Jubilant Food, which you like as well. There you have a price target of 11.31. Stock's actually at about 12.23, 12.24 or so. Can you talk about that? I guess, you know, with Jubilant, the basic bet has been same-store sales growing and the company adding more stores. But recently, the store addition pace has kept, has largely remained intact, consistent. But same-store sales growth has dropped very sharply.
Yeah, you see, Jubilant FoodWorks operates a very high-risk model. Because globally, if you look at most of the quick-service restaurants, there the company or the, you can say, the brand owner itself doesn't operate more than 10 to 20% of the stores, and the rest of them are franchises. But here in India, Jubilant FoodWorks is operating all its stores. So when the going gets beginning to add stores in the downturn, which is adding to your overheads and fixed costs, where the same store sales growth are not happening because of high inflation, because some of the plastic service tax, etc.
Okay, I think we've lost the audio there. Slightly patchy line today. We'll leave it at that, Amnish. I would have liked to hear your thoughts on Jubilant. It just got started, but hope you can come back and talk about this and more. Thanks very much, Amnish, for joining us. Amnish Agarwal, Senior Vice President at Prabhudas Leeladhar, talking about his ideas. ITC, Jubilant Food, we spoke about Britannia, and this Titan as well, which Amnish likes. We're going to take a quick break here. We'll come back in 2 minutes. A quick look at what's happening in the market, broader market. Neeraj Devan is going to be joining us well when we return.